Hello, this is a Katsuga primeval forest not far away from a very old Japanese town, Nara, the place of very old and very big trees. For example, this is a Japanese cryptomeria, one of the largest cryptomeria I ever seen in my life. So look how tall and how thick are these trees if they are left alone. Forest is sacred. And this is why it wasn't cut at all, this primeval forest, very few in Japan. Cryptomeria is a very interesting tree. It belongs to the group of conifers, which, while in a broad sense, called cupressophytes. So this is a Cupressaceae family, which is very broad, and in a broad sense, it includes, for example, cypress. So cypresses, junipers, and many other plants, and cryptomeria. Cryptomeria, however, belongs to the branch of Cupressaceae, which in the past was separated in its own very old kind of, well, half fossil family, because many fossils belong to that group, Taxodiaceae, Taxodium. And Cryptomeria is a sister group to American swamp cypress, to Taxodium. So typically, Cryptomeria doesn't have lots, for example, of resins, and it will rot pretty fast, and frequently nearby rivers, cryptomerias have like empty trunks and stay like on legs because the center of the trunk is already washed out with the water. However, sometimes cryptomerias demonstrate they are close to the other group of Taxodiaceae, to redwoods. Redwoods of California, beautiful giant trees, Sequoia and Sequoia dead, and look on them. This cryptomeria is definitely similar to American redwoods. So difference is obvious. The bark of cryptomeria is very thin. In, well, North America, in the Western North America, climate is what we call Mediterranean. So very dry. And you frequently hear about fires in California. How to survive these fires? Only with thick bark. So plants should grow fast, and when it's developed lots of bark, it will be protected from the low fires. So this is not the case in cryptomeria forest. As you see here, it's extremely humid. Like today, September 20th, I feel like humidity, like about 100%. And this is a stream nearby. So probability of fires still here, and fires are prohibited in Japanese forest. However, fires are relatively rare and not normal, comparing, for example, with California, where fires are regular. So the absence of thick bark is a difference of cryptomeria number one, and lots of smaller morphological differences. So overall, cryptomeria is frequently similar to, well, redwoods, but in a truth, like in a molecular way, in a phylogenetic way, it's closer to the swamp cypress. And sometimes, by the way, cryptomeria might even develop roots which occasionally go vertically, go up, like in a swamp cypress. From swamp cypresses, cryptomeria differs in another character. It is evergreen. However, if you look under the tree, you always find not a separate needles, but whole branches. So cryptomeria, redwoods, sequoia, sequoia dendron, taxodium, swamp cypress, and many other representatives of this cupressoid branch Taxodiaceae, are falling branches in the fall time, or like cryptomeria and redwoods do it all year round, like from small portions, and then become evergreen. So this is in a short the story about cryptomeria and how it is similar and dissimilar to American swamp cypresses and redwoods. Today again is September 20th. Thank you very much.